Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back again with another episode with the latest space news. Let's start with our first news regarding SpaceX's most rapidly reusable Falcon 9 booster. SpaceX's Falcon 9 booster, B1060, is now becoming the most rapidly reusable Falcon 9 booster. On the 7th of February 2021, the booster came back to Port Canaveral aboard the SpaceX drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, covering a journey of 400 miles from deep of ocean. Upon returning of booster, it was shifted to dry land surface. The booster, B1060, is now going through its refurbishment and renovation procedures. Just a number of days before it carried out the historic launches of Flying Twice in 27 days, which also earned the title of fastest reusable booster, on completing the launch of the 4th of February, which was a Starlink mission, SpaceX Falcon 9 booster, B1060, has also completed its launch for the fifth time. Falcon 9 booster B1060's Starlink 18 launch has officially broken NASA's 54-day space shuttle turnaround record and also has cleared out SpaceX's own previous record of 37 days turnaround by commencing launch just after 4 weeks of successful launch of TurkSat 5A mission. This is really a great leap for SpaceX. This booster effectively emerges as a first operational booster, completing the major goal of monthly reusability. Hoping they'll now move forward for weekly reusability. Richard Engel had tweeted on the 7th of February 2021, "Booster 1060 made it back to Port Canaveral this morning, just before a strong line of storms moved through. Having completed its fifth mission, let's see how fast SpaceX can get this Falcon 9 ready for its sixth flight. SpaceX fleet." SpaceX appears to have been progressing ahead for refurbishing the booster for a potential sixth launch within a short time span. The post-landing procedures are going on very fast as usual. It took nearly 2.5 days for SpaceX teams to transfer the booster into dry land from the drone ship, retract all the 4 landing legs, tilting the booster on one side, loading the booster into the transporter vehicle, and ultimately carrying the rocket by road to the processing hangar situated in the Cape Canaveral Air Force Base, Kennedy Space Center. Greg Scott tweeted on the 10th of February 2021, "A few minutes after my previous post, F9, B1060.5 heads back to the SpaceX hangar on the transporter for refurbishment and on to its next mission. Sooty from experience, but in great shape nonetheless. Notice the wear on the legs and grid fins. NASA Science, Elon Musk, SpaceX Fleet." SpaceX is going through close inspections and repairs, and they have nearly a score of days to perform another monthly reuse. SpaceX is rapidly speeding up their tempo of launch to carry out 48 launches in 2021. We all hope to see many more record-breaking launches and projects from SpaceX this year. Let's move to our second news with Elon Musk talking about Starlink IPO. Pre-orders for Starlink are open now. SpaceX has now started providing pre-orders for its Starlink internet service throughout the planet. SpaceX is taking pre-orders from all over the United States and other Starlink-approved countries like Canada, New Zealand, and Australia, and so on. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has said that the satellite clusters will be revealed to public openly once the cash flow of the internet service becomes predictable. Elon Musk tweeted on February 9, 2021, as a response to a Twitter follower who asked whether Starlink would be entering the public market soon. "Once we can predict cash flow reasonably well, Starlink will IPO." According to a report of February 2021, SpaceX Starlink's first public beta test has reached more than 10,000 users, and it seems initiating for a general release. SpaceX has already secured license approvals to provide Starlink internet service in the United States, Canada, and UK. Tyler Gray tweeted on February 9, 2021, "SpaceX's Starlink internet service is now available to a limited number of users per coverage area, as per the official website. Those that are currently participating in the Starlink beta program can place orders to acquire the service. People who are outside the current area of availability for the Starlink beta can place a $99 deposit to acquire the service once it becomes available in your region, net mid to late 2021, for example. Orders will be fulfilled on a first-come, first-served basis. SpaceX is offering open pre-orders with a refundable US$99 deposit and is offering a time period up to the middle of 2021 for service availability and shipping of user terminal. Musk has previously said that SpaceX's aim is to provide network connectivity at the same price in all countries, with the only differences in taxation and shipping. Adam Klotz, a Canadian resident, tweeted to Musk on the 9th of February, "You can now order Starlink. Hopefully the price comes down for us soon, though, Elon Musk." Musk had replied in tweet, "It's meant to be the same price in all countries. Only difference should be taxes and shipping." This tweet of Musk also shows that Starlink will be equally available for everyone at a similar price. Let's move into our next update now. A UK space company, Isotropic Systems, raised $40 million, or about 29 million pounds, for the development of next-gen broadband terminals, which will be used by a wide range of satellite systems in a round led by a satellite operator, SES. On Monday, February 8th, London-based Isotropic announced the new round of funding was led by SES, along with other investors such as Orbital Ventures, Boeing, Horizon X Global Ventures, Space Angels, and Firmament Ventures. British government's Future Fund was also listed in the name of participation. As per that funding, the company, Isotropic, now raised a total of $70 million. With that funding, Isotropic will continue to develop its flat panel multi-beam antennas. The company is now targeting early 2022 for enabling its first commercial system. They are also planning to expand the company's workforce from 70 to 110 people by the end of 2021. "The funding that we have gets us substantially close to product launch," Isotropic Systems founder and CEO John Finney stated. "As we grow our UK-based team, collaborative partnerships, and capabilities, we are proud to support tech innovation in the UK to solve connectivity challenges across a broad range of key vertical and geographical markets around the world." Steve Collar, as the CEO of satellite operators SES, helped Isotropic to raise $40 million in equity and grant funding. Collar said, "Isotropic's multi-beam antenna plays an important role in our multi-orbit strategy and is a key enabler for advanced satellite services on land, in the air, and at sea. Our investment reflects the potential that we believe this breakthrough technology has for SES and for the industry as a whole." Isotropic Systems now plans to operate a 20,000 square foot testing facility near its headquarters in the UK, which will create an opportunity to recruit 150 highly skilled engineers in the next 2 years. Now let's move on to our last segment as Lockheed Martin chooses ABL Space Systems for their launch. On the 7th of February, Lockheed Martin said that ABL Space Systems will execute a launch of their RS-1 rocket in 2022 from the Shetland Space Center, a spaceport under development in the island of Unst in the Shetlands. In the UK Pathfinder launch, the RS-1 rocket will deploy into orbit a tug developed by Moog that will later deploy 6 6U CubeSats. The $31 million contract between Lockheed and the British government, signed a couple of years before, comprises of a launch, construction of a spaceport at Sutherland in northern Scotland, and manufacturing Moog's orbital maneuvering vehicle. Nick Smith, regional director of Lockheed Martin Space, said, "We are absolutely committed to the success of this program, and the world-class capability that ABL Space Systems brings will allow us to build on our long-standing partnership with the UK and strengthen the growth of the UK space sector." Ian Annett, Deputy Chief Executive of the UK Space Agency, said, "We want the UK to be the first in Europe to launch small satellites into orbit, attracting innovative businesses from all over the world." Lockheed Martin's selection of ABL Space Systems for their UK Pathfinder launch brings us one step closer to realizing this ambition, putting the UK firmly on the map as Europe's leading small satellite launch destination. ABL said that its GSO launch system is totally self-contained, so it does not need any permanent infrastructure at the spaceport. Shetland Space Center will arrange for a flat, concrete-based launch pad, large stores of propellant and gas commodities. They'll also have Mission Control Center. An ABL spokesman said, "We are hoping to establish a regular launch cadence from Shetland Space Center, allowing us to better serve the European satellite market. We are beginning to formulate our European strategy and recently incorporated an ABL UK subsidiary to support these efforts." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.